approach of doing liquid deposition can actually make brand new designs that we've never even conceived of. So for example, I've talked about how we can go from soft all the way to hard. Well, suddenly you can design a part with that kind of variation in it. So this means that conventional design methods can actually be transformed. For example, right now, when a designer is thinking, I need this part to be a little stiffer and this part to be a little more flexible, they'll do that with thickness. They'll go, okay, well, I want this to be stiffer, so I'll make it thicker. And if I want it to be more flexible, I'll make it thinner. Well, here, what you can do is maintain that same thickness, but go from hard to soft and still get that range of durability. So if you think of the product designers having these pent-in limitations that they're boxed in with and they've been designing with, well, all of a sudden that just opens it way up. And it means that you can start to take, you know, and right now, when you're trying to join a hard material with a soft material, you have to worry about how strong that bond will be or how you're going to fix one part to another. Well, here it's all just going to be one continuous part. And while I can be inventive with chemistry, I just can't wait to see what designers and an innovative designer will be able to do with this. The ideal customer that we have is not just trying to make the same part that they've been making for forever. They're a company that recognizes that the 3D printing can give them a leg up and really advance their technology beyond where they've been able to take it before. They're able to take advantage of the designs of the system, and they're able to see that they're able to deliver to their customers needs that they haven't been able to meet before. And so that's really when we're able to develop systems that can fulfill the economic constraints, the cost constraints, and really deliver the technology that the market is looking for.